Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
All right, hello everyone. Got a little Theros 8-4 action for us here today. Diving into this pack, there are a couple of reasonable choices here. I think you can make a case for Fall of the Hammer or possibly Faded Intervention. Less so, you can't really make a case for Nyx Born Wolf. It's the next best card in the pack, but it's significantly worse than Faded Intervention, which is in the same color. So you're never going to end up taking that here. So I think that Fall of the Hammer is like a slightly better card. But I really don't like drafting red, even when it's wide open, because it's just so bad in the second two packs, that I'm going to go ahead and just take the Faded Intervention here. Like I said, I think it's a little bit worse, but it's in a much better color. And now looking at this pack, a lot of like decent cards. So Citizen, Oathsworn, Ferris Band Tromper are both like solid green cards. Drowned in Sorrow I think is actually pretty mediocre, and I have it being worse than Servant of Timuret in this set, because it actually doesn't kill that much. Everyone's building these huge Voltrons. Even like in the, you know, the aggressive decks tend to go deeper rather than wider, and so Drowning Star doesn't do as much against, you know, a Boros deck as it normally would. And then there's a Nyxborn Shieldmate, which is a very reasonable white common, and then Stratus Walk, which is okay. I'm gonna take a green card here just to stay in color since we led off with a green card, and there's no real reason to branch out. This early in the draft, I think I'm gonna take an Oathsworn over a Tromper because we have a lot of time to make it good. I in the past, I've leaned towards taking Tromper out of these two because I just really didn't like having to build around the Oathsworns. But let's give that a shot, I think, and see if we can make something happen there. And now we see a pack where the best cards are Archetype of Courage, which is exceptionally good. One of the better uncommons in the set, I think. Maybe it's like a little bit worse than a Chrome and Skyguard, but it's a very, very good card. But it is double white, and we already have a triple green and a double green card, so we're not really looking to take a white card here. Especially when it's next to this perfectly good green uncommon in Grave Robber Spider, which is a nice defensive card, even if you're not black, and if you are black, it's just kind of gravy. I think that Kragma Butcher is about the same power level as a spider, maybe even a little bit better, but I don't want to take a red card at this point, certainly not if we pass Fall of the Hammer. There's just no real reason to take red here. And then obviously Divination and Chorus of the Tides are both fine, so is Excoriate, so are Mortal Resolve. Those are all solid cards, but not anywhere near the level of Spider and Archetype. So since we have a triple green and double green, I think we can't take the double white card, even though Archetype of Courage is significantly better than Spider, and could be a signal that white is open, but I'll just take the Spider. And now we see a pack here with, interesting pack. There's Nyxborn Triton and Loyal Pegasus, both of which I like a lot, although I don't like Pegasus in the deck we're drafting. But here there's a Champion of the Stray Souls, which I think is a little undervalued mythic. It's certainly not exceptionally powerful, but it's very good in green-black. That's really its best home. When you get cards like Satyr Wayfinder and Communion with the Gods to fill up your graveyard, and then you can get, you know, Frieza's Menders and packs 2 and 3 to recur things. It's a great grindy card, and green-black is good at building these kind of grindy game plans. So the picker is really between Champion of the Stray Souls and Nyxborn Triton. I think Triton is objectively kind of a better card. And I may even like green-blue more than I like green-black, but I think Champion of the Stray Souls is a more interesting pick. And if you've watched kind of maybe some of Reed's drafts or Reed Duke's drafts in the top 8 of Philly, you know, he loves green-black. He has a tremendous amount of success with it, and I kind of want to try that out. So I'm going to take the Champion here. You don't get a lot of chances to play with Mythics, so when you do get them past you, and it's a reasonable choice, you know, feel free to, you can justify taking them. Although now getting seen as Loyal Pegasus here, I wish we were in white. Could have a great aggressive white deck. Maybe if we'd first picked that Fall of the Hammer, we'd have third picked the Archetype of Courage, and then taken Loyal Pegasus, and we'd have a great aggressive Boros start. But we didn't. So where we are now is choosing between Mellitus Astronomer, Flitterstep Eidolon, Necrobite, and Kragma Butcher. Same with the last Butcher, I don't want to move into red here. In the past, I got on my left as, you know, a great aggressive red-white deck, and hopefully not lose to him later. Here, for me, is between the Astronomer and the Necrobite. I think I'm going to take the Astronomer, actually. I know we did take Champion of the Stray Souls over the Nyxborn Triton, but Necrobite's so much worse than the Astronomer. And this gives us the option of moving back into green-blue potentially if it really is wide open. Now we're seeing a pack with a couple interesting choices. Repo Disown is a very powerful card, but the white ship really has sailed. We're not going to try to go into that direction at all. So Rise of the Choice here, and similarly with Oresco Sun Guide, if we take those little Pegasus, or Pegasi, we'd love to take Sun Guide, but for us, the choice is Servant of Timuret for Satyr Wayfinder. Servant of Timuret is just a much more powerful card, and while Wayfinder is synergistic with both the Grave Robber Spider and the Champion of Stray Souls, I think we'd want to take the Servant of Timuret here. We're looking to pick up Satyr Wayfinders for free, late, 8th, 9th, 10th pick, not to take them over better playable cards, even though they are synergistic. Now, seeing this pack, it's a pretty clear Sword-wise Centaur. We already have a triple green and a double green spell, so we're heavy green. This is the perfect deck for Sword-wise Centaurs. And one of the rewards for being heavy green in Born of the Gods is you typically do get these guys kind of late when green is open, so this is a nice pick. Other playables in the pack, obviously Unravel the Aether, being an instant speed answer to enchantments, is certainly a good card. I think it's a little bit worse than Sword-wise Centaur, so I'm going to go ahead and pass it. There are a lot of other replacement effects for that, so it's not something I'm going to put a priority on. And then Aisha X Adept is just kind of a mediocre guy. Man, so here we see another super late Oresco Sun Guide. I like that card a lot. Wish we had those little Pegasi and that Archetype of Courage, but we don't. But thankfully, we get to pick up another Servant Timuret right here over another Satyr Wayfinder. But again, Timuret, the Servant, is a much better card, and we're going to go ahead and take that, even though the Wayfinder is a little bit more synergistic. Opening pack returns to us. There's really nothing much here, but we knew that. The pack was pretty shallow when we passed it. I'm going to just take Forsaken Drifter just because the 4-2 body is good in some matchups. Now we have a choice between Marsh Mist Titan and Karametra's Favor. This Titan's not going to be very good in our deck, even if we end up being heavier black, because we have this double green, triple green. I can't imagine our Devotion of Black's going to get all that high, even if we are playing these two Servants and this Champion. So I'm going to go and take the Karametra's Favor. It's great putting that on a Servant. You can start draining them just with tapping it for mana. Now I'm going to take Necrobite over Aspect of Hydra and Fellhide Brawler. Necrobite synergizes nicely with the Servant of Timuret by giving a Death Touch. They'll be attacking their 4-4. They're two big guys in your one Servant. You can kill one this way, which is pretty nice. And it's very well disguised because you leave up the 3 mana to regenerate your Servant anyway. So it's a trick that they don't really see coming. So I like it a lot in this kind of a deck. And here we'll take Grizzly Transformation over War Chanter of Mogis, which is pretty easy. Pick up this Eye Gouge, and then pick up this Greatheart. Unfortunately, no Satyr Wayfinders late. They were just in the wrong packs for us. We saw them 6th and 8th, meaning they're not going to table. You're going to see them in the pack, 3rd and 4th pick, because those ones you can definitely get back. So that was unfortunate. Go ahead and also hide this Miletus Astronomer. Don't think we're going that direction. So, taking quick stock of where we are. Some perfectly solid green cards. Some pretty good black cards. Looking at this pack now, we have a couple interesting choices here. So there's Cavern Lampad. That's just the worst of the black cards, never taking this. So the rest of the choice really is Grey Merchant, Insatiable Harpy, we're never taking that, or Grey Merchant, really Fleece Mane Lion. So Fleece Mane Lion versus Grey Merchant is the choice. Could see it's going either way, to be honest. Fleece Mane Lion is a very powerful card, and we have a decent chance of being able to splash it easily since green has some good fixing. We already have this Karametra's Favor. We're trying to play a long game. There's a lot in favor of this lion in our deck. That said, Grey Merchant's a very powerful card, and it's on color and on plan. So I think I'm actually going to go in to take the Grey Merchant, even though I'm very, very tempted to take Fleece Mane Lion. If instead the Grey Merchant wasn't here, I would certainly take Fleece Mane Lion over Read the Bones and over Insatiable Harpy. But I think the Merchant's has a high enough power level on its own that we don't want to take the extra color there. But now I'm going to slam this Keepsake Gorgon, because Keepsake Gorgon's sweet. And then we have this pack where there's nothing we want. There's the Scholar of Athreos, which I actually don't mind splashing these kind of decks. Again, if we're trying to play a grindy game and the game does go long, Scholar is a very powerful splash card. Because you play it when you have 7 mana, you win the game almost in very few turns. Comparing that to the Nilia's Presence, which would help us with that splash, which card is going to be better for us? I think I'd rather take the Presence here than the Scholar. Typically, you'll see other Scholars. We don't even know what color we want to splash, but giving the Presence and the Favor means we can definitely splash whatever we pick up later. So I'm going to go ahead and take the Presence there. And here I'm going to take the Sedge Scorpion. Again, we want cards that draw the game out. let our late game powerful cards like Keepsake Gorgon and Champion of the Stray Souls take over. So I'm gonna take this Edge Scorpion over the Vulpine Goliath. And now I'm gonna take this Nilia's Disciple over Shipwreck Singer. Shipwreck Singer is not a card I love splashing. It just isn't impactful enough on its own. You play it late in the game. You want to play it early until it takes over the game out of a blue-black deck. So I'm going to take the Disciple here. And now, interesting. Choices here are Boons of Erebos, Karametra's Acolyte, and Perforce's Emissary. Emissary is not a terrible splash card, but we're not that aggressive. We have a lot of ways to win long games, so we don't really need to take this kind of a card. For me, the choice really is Acolyte versus Boon. I like Boon quite a bit, but I think I actually like Acolyte in this deck. We have a decent number of double green cards already, and green permanents. We have some good mana sinks in this Keepsake Gorgon and this Champion of Stray Souls. So I think this might be a Karametra's Acolyte deck. So I'm going to go ahead and take that. Not a pick I make every time there at all, but I think it's right there here. Ooh, now we'll pick up this Temple of Deceit. Again, further fixing our mana, so we can really easily splash blue cards now. So if we pick up... a Nimbus Naiad, or we see another Horizon Chimera, kind of one of the cards we'd like to splash, like this guy, we can do that, but Temple of Deceit will play even if we don't end up with any blue, because the Scry effect is quite powerful. And then, wow, this is a huge gift. Leaf Crown Dryad, super late. I think this is 8th. Just slamming that and not looking back. And then from the pack that we opened, this is the pack we took Grey Merchant. Cavern Lamp at tables, so that's an easy pick up here. There were 4 black cards in this pack, so it's not that surprising that something tabled. Sensational Little Heartbeat, Read the Bones, and then the green version that we took, ours, they're all gone. But, perfectly happy picking this thing up late. And here now, Opaline Unicorn, Guardians of Miletus, and Ferris Band Centaurs are all reasonable. I think we have enough ground defense that we don't need to prioritize the Centaurs. Oh, I don't mind having one for my sideboard. I'm actually going to take this Opaline Unicorn. I don't think we're going to end up playing it, but there's a chance that we might, if we get something we really want to splash and we don't think we have enough fixing for it, I could see playing this Unicorn. And now I'll pick up this the Cataclysmus is pretty bad, but occasionally it's a card you want to have access to. It's also kind of sweet with the Champion of Stray Souls. You can sacrifice it to get its effect. Mnemonic Wall is terrible in our deck. Even if we were going to splash it, there's no things that we want to bring back. So I'm going to actually take the Cataclysmus here. And now I'm actually going to take Guardians of Miletus over these two cards. I don't think we're ever going to want 2 Cataclysmus, and I think Guardian's a much better sideboard card than the Wanderer against the hyper-aggressive decks. Although now I will actually take a Wanderer over an Unknown Shores. Our fixing's already pretty good. I don't think we're going to want the Shores, and I don't mind Wanderer against the all-in red decks. I'm going to pick up another Guardian's Miletus. So now we have a very good sideboard plan against decks that are trying to kill us on the ground with, kind of aggressive white creatures, let's say. Although, unfortunately, the white deck's probably going to have multiple Loyal Pegasi, because we passed all those.